There's a really interesting element to the risks of the current system have traditionally been underplayed, but actually these risks from the linear economy, the sort of global challenges that we're seeing, those are real economic risks as well.
Welcome to The Green Renaissance, a podcast series from the Partnership for Action on Green Economy that aims to unpack the green recovery debate. This month, the switch from lines to circles, with COVID-19 highlighting the wastefulness of our current economic model, how do we embrace circularity as part of a green recovery? First, Miranda Schnitger, Government's Lead at the Ellen MacArthur Foundation.
So it goes beyond looking at what we can do within the current system to minimise our impact, but actually takes a sort of structural reform lens and thinks about how could we redesign our economy differently so that we are delivering economic development and value, but at the same time also we're creating solutions to these global challenges.
Next, Nugan Tass, Deputy Director of the Department of Environment at the United Nations Industrial Development Organization.
We have to ask how to change our behaviors so that products and materials and their value is available to create additional economic returns and conserve natural resources.
And finally, Paula Ijarroj, General Coordinator of CT Plus, the Plastics Technology Center in Uruguay.
¿Qué es lo que nos pasa a nosotros con lo material y qué necesidades tenemos desde lo material y qué es lo que nosotros estamos dejando atrás cuando necesariamente tenemos que recircularizar o desmaterializar la economía o volvernos más circulares?
Subscribe on SoundCloud, Spotify, or wherever you get your podcasts. I'm Colm Hastings, and this is The Green Renaissance.